guys, how's it going? Welcome to our channel, Cooking Like Antonio.
Today we're going to be reviewing Antonio's recipe for green gnocchi with tomato and mozzarella.
We have done our prep work. We are not going to make the gnocchi first. We're going to start by making a simple tomato sauce. And then we'll get that cooking, and then we'll go ahead and make the gnocchi. So for the tomato sauce, we're going to start by frying the garlic in a little bit of olive oil. So we'll go ahead and heat up the skillet and add the oil.
Adding the olive oil.
Yeah, so that is 6 tablespoons of olive oil.
Set that aside, and then we're going to add the garlic.
So that is 1 clove of garlic that has been peeled and crushed. Then we'll go ahead and cook that until it is soft. And then you just take a few minutes. You don't want to get it too hot and burn the garlic.
Okay, so the garlic is cooking nicely. I think we're just about ready. What do we add next? The tomato sauce?
So next we are going to be adding the tomato. Now the recipe calls for 500 grams of canned chopped tomato. Somebody in our family is not a big fan of chunks of tomato, so we...
That darn cat.
We are using a smooth tomato sauce instead. So we're going to add that. And then we're going to add 6 fresh basil leaves.
Put that aside, give it a little bit of a stir, and then we're going to add the basil leaves.
And you're just going to stir that in.
Oh boy. Too bad you folks at home can't smell this because it is great.
And then we are just going to season that with some salt and pepper. This is a very basic tomato sauce.
Add that some salt and pepper, pepper first.
Okay, so you have a generous amount of pepper in there. We're going to be adding some salt. And then we're just going to go ahead and put that aside on a burner. And then we'll be cooking, simmering for about 20 minutes. Okay, we have our tomato sauce cooking. It's simmering nicely there. It should be done in about 20 minutes. So now we are ready to go ahead and prepare our gnocchi. So we have our potatoes that have been mashed. And that was 500 grams of floury mashed potato. And to that, we'll be adding our cooked spinach.
Right now there. Okay, so we have some cooked spinach right here. Let me go ahead and add to that potato.
And that is about 200 grams of spinach cooked. And then we'll be adding our flour.
Okay.
Which is 110 grams of plain flour.
Okay. And that's added.
And then we will be cracking 1 egg into that.
I have not mastered the art of doing it with one hand yet, but that will do. So what is our egg?
Probably I'm not going to try that on camera.
Probably not.
Practice it on camera.
Okay, so we go ahead and mix this together.
Mix everything together.
Okay.
And then Antonio does say that if the mixture is a little bit too wet, you can add a little bit of additional flour to that.
Okay, we have mixed it together. We're going to go ahead and add just a little bit of pepper and a little salt to this. Just spice it up just a touch. Okay.
And when you think you're ready to go, you're going to go ahead and get our big cutting board and make our shapes.
Okay, we're going to take some dough. We've already done one and get the hang of it a little bit. The idea is to take a little dough and roll it almost into like a cigar type shape. Roll it out and kind of do what we want it to do. And again, figure this is our first attempt at this. We think that's about right, probably.
That looks pretty good to me.
Okay, and then when we cut it, oh, I don't know, that's about an inch and a half.
Yeah, it's, the recipe says 3 centimeters. I'm not sure what that is. Inches.
Okay, and without doing the conversion, I'm going to go by what I'm a little more familiar with. It's about an inch, inch and a quarter, something like that. There we go. A little longer. You take the fork and just kind of press down like so on the top. Back together.
So the purpose of making the little ridges is for it to hold more of the sauce.
Okay, we brought a pot of water to boiling. Just like you would with pasta, we're going to go ahead and add some salt right to that water. And then we're going to go ahead and put our raw gnocchi in the water.
And as you can see, just with those few ingredients, that actually made quite a few gnocchis. I mean, that could probably easily, what, be about 4 people?
I would say so.
Yeah, it is supposed, the recipe is, does say that it serves 4 people.
Are we thinking with the entire plate in here?
If you don't think it's big enough, then we can do it in batches. It's up to you. So the gnocchi only takes a few seconds to cook, according to the recipe. Once they pop to the surface, they should be ready. As you can see, we had our tomato sauce done, and as soon as they float to the top, you will scoop them out and add them directly to
I believe I'm not going to put too many more in there for this first batch. It's going to stick together with the touch. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and set that aside and recover that. It's starting to boil again, but I'm going to recover that so it comes back. It will boil a little faster. Okay, and we do have some starting to float to the top, and we're going to go ahead and add that right to our sauce. It does look good. Okay, and he was correct. That does not take very long to cook at all. And they're practically all floated to the top now. They do cook rather quickly.
We are scooping out the last few gnocchis, and we are going to coat that in the sauce and add the parmesan cheese, and then we are ready to plate it up and do the taste test.
And they do cook much, much faster than pasta. So go ahead and add the parmesan.
Yep.
Okay. We're going to go ahead and add that and mix that in.
And that is 40 grams of fresh grated parmesan.
Go ahead and mix that into our sauce here, our gnocchi.
And once everything is mixed and coated, we will plate it up and top it with a little bit of fresh grated mozzarella. Now, the recipe does say that you should use buffalo mozzarella. We are not going down that road. We've tried the buffalo mozzarella before. It's really, really good. But we just had regular mozzarella
on hand, yeah.
Yeah, that's what we had, so we're using that. We have an entire video where we compare the buffalo versus the regular mozzarella, and I'm quite happy to use the grated mozzarella for this.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll be back in a minute for the taste test.
Mamma mia!
Okay, the moment of truth. We're ready to do the taste test.
Our finished product, and I have to say it does look good.
It looks really good.
So
let's go ahead and see
what... A little taste here. Pretty good.
That's really good. It's soft. The tomato sauce for this is really, really delicious.
The spinach works nicely with it. They all kind of complement each other. That is a good meal.
Yep. I have to say, I'm giving Antonio a thumbs up on this one, and We definitely try it again.
And I don't think we did too badly for our first shot.
No, this is really tasty.
Yep, and it did taste pretty good.
So we're going to go ahead and add some meatballs to this and go and have dinner. And so until next time guys, goodbye.
Yeah, goodbye, and I hope you try this.
I wasn't sure I was going to like the tomato sauce, but I do.
I do like the tomato sauce, yes.